India has become number one in test matches again by defeating New Zealand by 178 runs at Eden Gardens. It was a comprehensive win, as was the win at Green Park, Kanpur, in the first test match. And I have with me Sandeep Ji to discuss what are the takeaways from this game. Sandeep, what do you think? Where this Indian team is going ahead, shaping ahead of a very long season?
Shaping up really well, like the last couple of test matches, especially we won on pretty good surfaces. It augurs well for the long season.
Right.
The way we won and the way we came back from a certain tricky scenarios in the first test as well as the second test. Like the first test, the third day when Kane Williamson and second, I guess, Kane Williamson and Latham were batting well, and how we came back from that juncture. And in generally, we have shown that bounce back ability. Whenever we were down,
right.
we had the ability to fight back and force a result.
Yes.
Force a positive result.
I mean, yes.
And through a concerted effort, team effort. It's not just Ashwin or Jadeja who's now sitting in the wickets. Even Mohammad Shami, and even when we were a few wickets down in the tail, how the lower order batsmen have emerged and shoulder utility.
Yes.
That augurs
yes.
really well for India in the next few.
Tell us about the significance of being number one. Rankings, do they matter? Do they don't matter?
Kohli's rankings doesn't matter, but of course it does matter. It's a culmination of their good effort, good work.
But the ranking changes after every match. So
yeah.
What is the importance?
The importance will be to sustain the ranking, to maintain the number one ranking, and
to sustain the ranking will be important, as Sandeep Ji is saying. And this Indian team has shown that they can do it because they have a character in them. There were times, as Sandeep said, when Indian team was down and out, but every time they fought back. And specifically, what is most heartening is the fight back that the tail has shown. Every time in Kanpur or Eden Gardens, whenever the chips were down, Saha came in, or Ashwin chipped in, or Jadeja chipped in with the bat or ball for that matter. But specifically, I want to talk about Saha. Saha has become that anchor in the team that was missing after Dhoni had left. You have seen his evolution. Tell us about it.
Yeah, Saha, in Sri Lanka, it all started in Sri Lanka a little bit. Saha, he was not very fluent.
In Sri Lanka,
he had a little bit of nerves. Like he was not looking assured in Sri Lanka.
Yeah, and last year. Right.
But then all of a sudden, even he goes to West Indies, and West Indies, he got a lot of very important runs for us, especially in Gros Islet. The 100 was, India were like 5 down for 116 runs. Even Rohit Sharma was out. So how he fought an alliance with Ashwin.
Right.
Both of them are very important for India's
right.
Evolution and how India eventually ended the number one ranking. Like the times when Saha, it's been a coming of age season for Saha.
Right.
Like we all know, he's abundantly talented in and shown his prowess in the domestic circuit, but not quite an international front. Like, but there have been occasional instances when he's sipped in the quick 25-30, but not beyond that. Now he's shown that he can actually modulate his pace also.
Right,
like
right.
When they wanted runs, he's gone.
Now I specifically want to ask, have we found another MS Dhoni in the test team?
Yeah, I mean in home conditions certainly we do have found, not
but in away conditions Dhoni wasn't spectacular either.
Yeah.
So we can agree on this fact that we have found a new Dhoni.
Not quite as much as Dhoni. Maybe 10 more test matches again will show whether he's comparable to Dhoni or whether he actually is as good as Dhoni. But
right.
Of course he has that knack of scoring runs under pressure like Dhoni in
and
India.
If I have to take one thing away from the Indian team, or to that extent the fight that the tail has shown and Saha has shown, is the fact that we haven't been batting in the fourth innings. Now it certainly is nobody's fault. Our man Kohli is lucky enough to win all tosses at home, but do you think I want to imagine you a scenario where Kohli has lost the toss in Eden Gardens or in Kanpur. So do you think that this team had it in them to win, to bat actually that beautifully in the fourth innings and chase a target?
Yeah, these guys are pretty used to batting on third days, fourth days surfaces and fifth days surfaces. So especially like Al Rahane, Pujara.
Right.
And so won't be that much of a difficult thing to do. I mean, it probably is a mindset issue.
Right.
How you go about it and
I ask you because we have a long season ahead.
Yeah.
And there will be his luck is going to run out at some point in time, Kohli's
definitely,
luck.
Yeah.
So there will be times where we'll be finding ourselves batting in the fourth innings.
Yeah.
So considering that, you know, the grit, the gumption that we have shown, can we also show it in the fourth innings while chasing a target?
Yeah, there's no reason why we can't actually, because of the versatility of a few batsmen like Pujara, Kohli, right, and Rahane,
yeah,
and guys like Murali Vijay.
That's right.
They've all shown their adaptability in batting.
And Rohit Sharma?
Rohit Sharma.
What do you make of him? I mean,
he's 82, probably his best test innings, I presume. Like, the first couple of innings, yeah, his first two centuries were also important, but this was possibly his best knock.
Okay.
Yeah, given the conditions, given the pitch, a little bit of up and down wicket, variable bounce. You know, he batted very fluently. Last time he was batting on a different wicket.
Right. So we have won the series, but a couple of things are still remaining. For example, the opening conundrum.
Yeah.
Now, Dhawan is also out. He was out of form anyway. He's not out, I mean, technically, but you know, he has a thumb injury. Rohit, you have a scenario where Rahul is also not batting.
Yeah.
So do you think that we are going to go back to Gambhir? Is it a retrogressive step?
Yeah, it is a little retrospective step, but we can't help.
But what options
can we have? That's the biggest issue. Abhinav Bogan is a little uncut, I guess, for international scene.
Right.
So is Mayank Agarwal. Mayank Agarwal certainly doesn't look like, you know, he's going to burst on international scene and score a lot of runs. But
right.
So he went for a safety first option, you know, Gambhir is experienced, like 56, 57 test matches and all those 4,000 runs. So,
Great.
Yeah, they can't be blamed for going back to. I don't know whether it's a long term option, but certainly.
Okay, so the final test match is starting on October 8th, and we have two things to look forward to. Will India be able to complete the whitewash? Two, who's going to open alongside Murali Vijay? Stay tuned.